So welcome back again for today's class on engineering graphics. Today we'll be solving one problem related to pentagonal lamina. So everyone know a pentagonal lamina will be having five sides or five edges. So this is one side, second side, third, fourth and fifth side, right? So these points are called as the corners and these are called as either the sides or the edges. Okay, so a pentagon will be having five sides. So if you consider this, everyone know how to construct a pentagon. So you will take an interior angle of 108 and the exterior angle will be of 72 degree, right? So now what's the question is, in the question it is told it is a pentagonal lamina of all side equal to 25 mm. And it is how rested? It is told it has been resting on HP with one of its side. Okay. So, these are the sides. So, you have to rest the position of the pentagonal lamina in this way. So, it is resting on HP with one of its side. So, this is a pentagonal lamina. If it is resting on one of its side, the entire pentagonal lamina should be parallel to our horizontal plane. So, this will be the position of the given pentagonal lamina which is resting on one of its side on HP, means entire lamina will be parallel to HP plane and this will be the side or the edge which will be resting on HP. So, if this is the position of the pentagonal lamina, so when you view from the top, what you will be seeing, you will be seeing a pentagonal lamina, right? And then if it is shifted down, then you will see a pentagonal lamina in this position. So, this will be our top view, right? Because this will be the alignment. So, the side which is resting on HP will be perpendicular to our VP plane. So, when you have the position of the pentagonal lamina in this way, so when you view from the top, you will see a pentagonal lamina as a top view. The same thing when it is viewed from the front. So, the projection line from the corner will be viewed on the vertical plane. So, you will be just seeing a straight line as our front view. So, you will be seeing a straight line as our front view. And when you view from the top, you will be seeing a pentagonal lamina. So, we know that horizontal plane will be tilted down. So, you will be having a pentagonal lamina in the top view. And you will be having the projection of the pentagonal lamina here above just as a straight line. So, first you will draw XY plane. So, it is told a pentagonal lamina of edge 25 mm. It is resting on one of its edge. So, always when it is told resting on one of its edge, you have to first show the edge. So, edge here is of dimension 25 mm, right? So, you will then after drawing 25 mm, just take the interior angle as 108 or the exterior angle will be 72 from both the directions. Then you measure 25 mm exactly how much it is cut an arc. Measure 25 mm how much it is cut an arc. Both will come along the same line. Mine is not as per the dimension. Again from here you measure 25 mm and you cut an arc. From here you measure 25 mm and you cut an arc. So where it meets, you join, right? So then you can name it as A, B, C, D and E. So this is our top view. After this, what is our duty? We have to take the projections above. And I told that the front view just looks like a line. So you take the projection from C, projection from D and projection from E. So, to do the naming, the observer views from here. So, when the observer views from here, A will be visible, E is coming on the same line, but that will be hidden. So, you will write A dash in the bracket E dash. Similarly, when the observer views here, B and D comes along the same line. B will be visible and D will be hidden. So, you will write B dash in the bracket D dash. And here C will be visible directly. So, this is C dash. So, you please darken our front view also. So this is the first stage, front view and top view as per the question. So it is showing it is resting on one of its edge in HP. Hence you started with the top view and then came to the front view. If you had given information with respect to VP, we have to start from the front view and then come to the top view. So this is done. So next we have to see the inclination with respect to HP always when we start up the problem related to HP. Okay. So next is what's happening here, such that the surface makes an angle of 60 degree with HP. So this is the surface of the front view now. So this surface is now being tilted to 60 degree with HP. So leave some space and fix this edge. You know this already, A dash and E dash. So from this you measure the distance, how much it is exactly. Before cutting an arc, please draw 60 degree to HP. Keep one end of the compass here and draw 60 degree. On this 60 degree line, you measure this distance and you cut an arc. So it meets somewhere. So this point will be our C dash. Along with this, you should know the point B dash and D dash. Again, from A dash to E dash, from there you measure what is the distance from A dash to B dash here. And similarly, you come and cut an arc. So it will meet at some point. So this will be B dash of D dash. So now we inclined our front view to 60 degree to HP. Then you take the projection down from A dash, E dash, from B dash, D dash, from C dash. After that, you extend the projection from locus of D, from locus of E, from locus of C, from locus of A and locus of B. After that, you try to identify the points. So this is the locus of A. Locus of A dash is meeting here. So this is our point A. And then this is the locus of B. B dash is meeting here. So this is our point B. After that, this is the locus of C. C dash is meeting here. So this is our point C. And this is the locus of D. D dash is meeting here. So this is our point D. This is the locus of E. And E dash is meeting here. So this is our point E. So we got all the points. After getting all the points, you have to join A to E, A to B, B to C, E to D and D to C. After joining, please darken it. So this is the second stage. So this is our front view in the second stage and the top view in the second stage. This will be the true shape of the top view, and in the second stage it will be a little bit compressed, so you'll be getting the apparent shape of the top view in the second stage. So after the completion of the second stage, let us go to the third stage details. It is told the edge on which it rests. So this is the edge in which it has been resting. So now this edge is inclined at 45 degree to VP, right? So 45 degree to VP, you can take either this way or this way. I'm just taking 45 degree to VP. So which is the side which is resting in HP? AE. So now this side or the edge has to be shifted to 45 degree to VP. Since it is the problem resting on edge distance in the second stage also will be the same distance. See, you are projected parallelly. The true length of the side here is equal to the true length of the side here also. So no need of determining beta angle. You leave some distance, convenient distance down and fix this point. If this is not possible, you can also take another option. Okay, so just draw a parallel line to XY line and take 45 degree line if the space isn't constrained. Okay, so then you can rub this little bit. So now you will fix this point. E, you can fix it. And measure this distance and cut an arc. So you will get the point A. So you got A and E. So this is the edge which has been resting in HP. The same edge now has been inclined to 45 degree to VP. 45 degree you can take directly on the XY line, or you can just draw a line parallel to XY line, and from there you can take 45 degree line if space is the constraint. So then after knowing this, you have to construct the entire part. So how do you construct the entire part? For that you should know this distance. To know this distance, first you find out the midpoint of A and E. So midpoint of A and E is this. So you identify this distance, how much it is. From there you cut an arc. You get this midpoint. So from the midpoint you just draw a perpendicular line. This is the midpoint. From the midpoint just draw a perpendicular line. So after joining perpendicular line, what is our intention now? You need to find out the corner D, B and C. So from the midpoint you see exactly how much is distance is. So from the midpoint just measure the distance for C, how much it is, and you cut an arc. So that provides you C. So this D and B is lying below C. So you find out this distance, how much it is. Okay. So same thing, you cut an arc over here. So you got this point. After getting this point, you just draw a line perpendicular. So this line is exactly perpendicular to this. So you will draw an perpendicular line. After drawing perpendicular line, from this corner A, you measure this distance, how much it is B. It is lying on the same locus, right? What we have drawn. So measure the distance A to B, how much it is. So A we have already. From A, you measure distance B, how much it is. You cut an arc. So you got the point B. Similarly, from E, you measure this distance E to D is how much. So keeping the same, you just cut an arc. You will get the point D. So this C you have got already. So you will join A to B, A to E you have got already, E to D, B to C and C to D. So now you have shifted the second stage of the top view to 45 degree line. Means the edge now is being tilted to 45 degree line. So after getting the top view in third stage, we have to take the projection above. So to take the projection above, draw the locus from B, draw the locus from C, from A, from D, as well as from E also. Then you take the projection from C, from B of D dash. Okay, this is already on the XY line. So then you start reading the locus. So this is the locus of A, and A dash is lying here. So this will be our point A dash. And this is the locus of E. E dash is also on the XY line. So this will be our E dash. So then this is the locus of B. And locus of D dash is here. So this will be our D dash. After this, this is the locus of B. Locus of B is meeting B dash at this point. So this is B dash. Okay. Then you have the locus of C. C is meeting with C dash here. Okay. So after this, you will join A dash to E dash. A dash to B dash. B dash to C dash to D dash, and D dash to E dash. So this is how you get the problem. Okay, so if you have constructed this below, so you will be getting the front view in this way. If you are constructing the edge above this line, so you will be getting it this way. So this is how you have to solve the problem in case of pentagonal lamina. So if it is resting on HP, we will start from the front view, so from the top view, and then go for the front view. But you have to see whether it is resting on one of its edge or one of its corner. If it is corner, first you have to write the corner, and then the side comes this way. If it is side, first you have to show the side, and the corner will be facing in opposite direction. Thank you.